The International Health and Temperance Association of Seventh-day Adventists celebrated its division-wide temperance contest. On 27th November, we brought What All Happened to You, and the students spoke so eloquently. Let's now see the continued portion of the elocution competition by the high school and post-high school students.
Lifestyle is obviously termed from words of life and style. The style someone lives his or her life. Lifestyle is a way of living based on identifiable patterns of behavior, which are determined by the interplay between an individual's personal characteristics, social interaction, socioeconomics, and environmental living conditions. This explanation implied that lifestyle is a generic concept that could mean several things to different people at different times. For example, regular physical activity, homosexuality, vegetarianism, asceticism, polygamy, gluttony, Rastafarianism, and many other qualify as lifestyle. Therefore, in reality, there is no such a thing as optimal lifestyle, but an act of contemporary health culture. People compare their own achievements with those of others and end up feeling frustrated and dissatisfied with their own lives. Thank you. God bless each and everyone.
Lifestyle is the way or style of living. It includes patterns of behavior, work, activity, consumption, interaction, and interest that describes how a person spends his or her time. Now complaints about shortage of time. This shortage of time ended up in fast food system, home delivery system, and in the growth of event management companies. Homemakers resorted to mixers, grinders, washing machines, etc. The exorbitant growth of mobile phone network system accelerated the speed of communication, but witnessed the collapse of social face-to-face contact and communication. Let us be true lovers of nature with an aesthetic sense. Let us cultivate a sense of responsibility. Let us be good citizens with a better civic sense. Let us protect the Ganges and keep the Himalayas as Himalayas. This universe is a perfect blend. Man should uphold its sanctity and make a heaven of it. With this, I conclude my words. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Why life changes are important for modern life. We are all proud of the age we live in, the age of science and technology that has brought sick changes in our lives. From the moments we wake up in the morning to the moments we return to bed at night, all our daily activities are directly or indirectly done by machines. We proudly refer to this as modern lifestyle. Certainly, life changes are the key to contemporary life. But we have to make sure whether it is healthy or not. According to WHO, 60% of factors relating to health depends on the drastic metamorphosis in lifestyle. In this era, where cheese has been surpassed by donkeys, traveling not a rickshaw has been replaced by aeroplane, Western clothing is favored among the masses than traditional clothing. Students are blessed with pre-eminent education. The complexity of house construction has been augmented. And mankind receives unbeatable hospitality through vaccines, medicines, decreasing the escalating mortality rate. Your life does not get better by chance. It gets better by change. Thank you.
There are many lifestyle changes in the human beings because the human lifestyle, the human beings have a number of lifestyles changing in their day-to-day lives. So the human beings are changing their lifestyles because the seasons also changing, the human beings also changing their lifestyles. So once, if we observe the picture, what you have shown here, so this is about the ancient days and the present, the current days. We can see, we can observe the picture here. So here is the past life. We can see the past life is whole of the green, whole of the nature. Whole of the nature is very green, and whole of the villages, and we can see all the plants and everything is very green and very beautiful. So the human beings, they are in the ancient days, they are kept the nature very beautifully, but the days are passing like that slowly, slowly. If we come down here, here we can see the present life. The present life with the people, we are destroying the nature, slowly we are destroying the nature, and the nature has slowly destroyed and the pollution entered into the nature.
The modern lifestyles are having number of advantages, which includes easing people's lives, saving the hundreds of people by developing the new medicines and vaccines. On the other hand, different modern lifestyle pattern will negatively affect to our health by physically and psychologically or socially. One of these way of living is highly intake of fast foods. This will due to some specific reasons, such as short time specified for eating or choosing healthy food, lack of physical activity combination. Please don't you eat the fast foods. Try to save your health. What is my conclusion is, stop to eat fast foods. Start to eat vegetables and fruits. Don't dare to drag your mind into the danger zone or to the social media. I mean, it will kill your educational life. It will spoil your spiritual life. At last, what I want to tell you all is, delete your all flashbacks from the mindsets and restart your mind with the graceful thoughts of Jesus Christ, and He will bless us. Thank you.
Lifestyle changes are very necessary for this present generation, as most of them are extremely addicted to smartphone, TV, social media, drinking, smoking, drugs, living relationships, and many more. Today, the lifestyle is changed and misused by many. Nowadays, the lifestyle is misused because of health and technology. Health is like this. People are overworked and suffer from ill health, while some people don't work and suffer from ill health. 80% of our health disorders can be cured if we use our body the way we should use it. 10% by eating the right food and 10% by living in a good environment. Not even health, even technology. Advancement in technology has brought a great change in our lifestyle too. Do you know addiction to smartphone, TV, video games has brought a great change in our lifestyle too? It has betrayed our brain potential, economic potential, psychological potential, creative potential, human potential, and many more. Why? Because we are hooked and hijacked by a screen.
Lifestyle changes are important in modern life, but the changes must represent your character. If not, you have lost everything. Choose to become a vegan or vegetarian, consuming wholesome, plant-based diet with organic, fresh vegetables and fruits, and prevent lifestyle diseases and health disorders like diabetes, heart diseases, hypertension, etc. Honesty is the best policy. Thank you.
Why it is necessary for modern children to change their lifestyle? Modern lifestyle have number of advantages, like it saves hundreds of lives and give a new and an easy life to us. But on the other aspect, if you see, it have negative effects on human psychologically, mentally, socially, hygienically, and even physically. But technology, which you can say it makes you healthy, it saves our time, but on the other aspect, it makes you lazy and even waste your time, and the ample use of it may also affect your body. One side you can say it's a luxury, but other hand side if you see, it makes you lazy. The way we eat today is far different we eat before, because 12% of the teenagers can be overweighted adult due to this. They don't know how to differentiate between healthy and unhealthy food. They eat what they get. As it is said in a rhyme, no, early to bed, early to rise makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise. Before, the grandparents used to live with the family and play a very vital role for the upbuilding of a characteristic for small children. They used to tell moralful and emotional stories so they may upbuild the characteristic emotionally with the society. Anything which is against the society, moral values or scriptures is bad, and bad thing, and even hell. And bad things should be changed immediately. Thank you.
Today, I stand before you to talk for a short while on the topic, the value of traditional game as an alternative to virtual games. First of all, let me tell you about what traditional games are. Traditional games are those games within a society that people played for many years. These games are played indoor as well as outdoor. Some of the Indian traditional games of India include lambs and tigers, cards, chess, snake and ladder, pachisi, kancha, hopscotch, gilli danda, kho-kho, kabaddi, dopke, and so on. In this changing world where fashion changes every week, even these traditional games are being replaced by virtual games. It is obvious that it is increasingly harder for traditional games to compete against the ever-growing innovations of screens that craps the attention and offers many different entertainment options. What would you want to be? A weak and unhealthy superhero of the virtual world, or a strong and healthy superhero of the real world? The choice is yours. Think wise and act wise. Thank you for being an amazing audience. Thank you.
Traditional games are those games which can be played with minimum equipment, which children are able to learn by the example of other children, which can be played without any reference to written rules and regulation. That is, they can be played with oral rules and regulation. And these games are very beneficial for us because these games gives us many things like creativeness in our body, imagination in our mind, enthusiasm in our body, maintaining thinking skills, maintaining strategies, mind, etc. And it is also proved in many researches that like kho-kho, kabaddi, gilli danda, five stone, leg hopping, these games are group game. And when we have a group game, we are able to converse with each other by laughing, by giggling, by smiling. And thus this contributes to our maintaining communication skill and maintaining our social interaction with each other. So at this point, I want to conclude that our traditional game were better because our traditional game not only make us mentally, physically, socially, psychologically, but wholly fit. And if we don't have health, how can we enjoy our wealth? Thank you and have a great day.
The value of traditional games. How many of us give importance to our own traditional games? It is so obvious that it's becoming really harder for our traditions to compete against the ever-growing invasion of screens around the house that grabs the attention of the youngest. Traditional games have been passed down from one generation to another that have their origin to go back centuries. But with the passing of time, they've been forgotten and are not passed on to the youngest generation due to the modern lifestyle and growing alienation. Several traditional games involve group play, such as Antakshari, Damsharaks, and I'm sure you'll never forget the memories these games gave you. Traditional games are rather sedentary. Several traditional games, such as kho-kho, kabaddi, hopscotch, involves a significant level of physical activity. Even traditional board games seem to have physical benefits, you know. However, these games do not require any expensive gear, but helps in building the life skills and also pass on our heritages to bridge generations. Traditional games helps a person in improving his creativity, imagination, camaraderie, physical health, interpersonal relationships, and so on. But what does these PUBG and Free Fire give you? Camaraderie, physical health, or at least interpersonal relationships? My friends, these are not traditions, but illusions. Traditional games offers a treasure trove of culturally different, inclusive and enjoyable ways to achieve physical activity in contrast with participation in competitive sports. Our culture, our language, our tradition are the base upon which we built our identity. Thank you all. Have a nice day. Jai Hind.
For you all to talk to you about cigarette smoking is just the hub. Have you heard of the advertisement? With cigarettes in my hand, I felt like a man. Ooh, that sounds nice. But be aware of cigarette smoking. Do you know how smoking affects your body? It can affect your lungs, cause lung cancer, cause heart cancer, cause eye problems. It can cause skin cancer. But do you know, every pack of cigarette smoking says, cigarette smoking is just a... The Holy Bible says, our body is the temple of God. I'm so sad to see people smoking everywhere, but children like you and me become passive smokers by breathing the poisonous smoke. Today, let us join our hands together to protect our family and friends. Let us make an effort to make our environment smoke-free. Let us educate a smoker to quit smoking, because it can kill you. The coffin nails will bury you. The graveyard will swallow you. So let us make a difference. Thank you.
Let's now hear to what the judges had to say listening to these wonderful kids talking.
Many kids came. They came like a cool cat. I thought, you know, what they're going to talk and then how they're going to be expressing themselves. Oh my God, when they opened the mouth, superb. It was pin drop silence for the entire crowd, including all the judges here. Lot of new informations, which is beyond their level of studies at the moment, at the age. And the kind of expression, kind of tone in the language, though they had a time rush. But still, the kids really opened up. Some of the kids have opened up very well, extremely very well. And then they went on, kept the tempo till the last minute. And I, being a scientist, I thought I knew many things, but when the kids spoke about nutrition, plant, environment, quite a few things are amazing, new to me. Thanks Dr. David for inviting me here to come and be a judge. More than the judge, I too learned a lot. Thank you, kids, wish you all the best. Thank you very much.
It was a wonderful experience for me. I have to admit, I learnt very much. I was very impressed with the enthusiasm, with the energy that the young people today are showing us. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. I remember learning one thing from my parents, that there is only one way to do a task, the best way. And after finding the best way, then go and try and find a better way after that. And I was reminded of that today. I saw young children speak so well, and then after that, you think this is going to be the best, the first speech you hear, and then the next one, and the next one, and everyone is equal or better. It was inspiring. Thank you very much for your energy, and I hope that this will continue throughout your lives. All the very best.
You came forward as the cream of your institutions. And when you came on stage, you proved that you are more than the cream. Well done. Keep up the tempo. And I am sure that whatever you spoke about, you will practice in life, and you will also set an example for others to follow. All the best. Thank you very much.
With the advancement in the technology and modernization, we all are moving towards an easy life, where we try to tell our children and give all the comforts to their children, not making them to struggle, work hard, or do anything. So it is not that we don't want, it is the love out of parents which force them to do something which they shouldn't do. These things are causing many ill effects in the society, like love toward the children, make them to give all the gadgets, electronic gadgets, making them to get tuned or addicted to those things, and which is leading to many other problems, which many young speakers, they told so nicely, and the energy level and the confidence in them was so high. It was really a great experience for me to be a part of this event. I thank Dr. Edison for giving me an opportunity to be a part of it and enjoying the speakers who spoke so well and coming from the every part of the country, and with their own internal selection and evaluation, they had come here. As said by one of my fellow judges, that when they came, they were coming so humbly. We thought that what is that they're going to speak, but the moment they opened their mouth, we were all really, we were really impressed. So it was a very good experience. We had a very nice time in the morning hours, and the whatever spoken by them, I advise all the children to try to follow what you have spoken here. And all the other participants in this event, those who are not able to come on the stage and speak on the, any subject, should be able to take points out of these speakers, what they have said, and try to imbibe in their day-to-day life. My general advice to all the children who are going to be the future citizens and responsible citizens is that have a focused mind in your life, set a goal, and try to achieve it. With these few words, I once again thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity to be a part of it, and I really enjoyed being a part of this thing. Thank you.
As a part of the valedictory ceremony, prizes were given for competitions held on the day one. Prizes were awarded for the best elocutions under each section of primary school, middle school, high school, and post-high school. Prizes and awards in appreciation to the fantastically delivered speeches were awarded based on the division, primary school, middle school, high school, and post-high school. Presentation of recognition and awards were given to the best union and best participating health ministries among the participating unions. The two-day division-wide temperance contest 2019 came to an end with a cultural evening. This event brought forth a lot of energy and enthusiasm among the children, participants, and the participating unions. This brought us to the conclusion of the 2019 division-wide temperance contest.